Jerry Jones is the issue. Jason Garrett is the symptom. If you have a runny nose, that's not the
You sound like my naturopathic sickness. Doctor. You can take this symptom. Medicine, Molly, but it's
you
not going to really cure you.
You got to clear up the sickness itself. Now, Jerry Jones had a big ego, kind of media savvy, if not liked, coach in Jimmy Johnson. They were in the middle of a Super Bowl dynasty. Mm-hmm. Got rid of him for Barry Switzer. The next time he had a big personality like that, it was Bill Parcells. Didn't last long. He is the issue. The head coach is the issue. And let me tell Cowboys fans if and when it'll change. When Jerry Jones feels his mortality coming, when he feels the end is near, or when he starts to lose it, if and when that ever happens, and the football people really take over more. This is what happened to George Steinbrenner. This is the truth. And the football people take over more, it'll be better for the Cowboys. What happened when he gave Stephen Jones a little more control? They didn't draft Johnny Football. Mm-hmm. They drafted offensive line. That's what set this whole thing up. Jason Garrett is the, like, right now, if they had a great coach, I might pick him to win the Super Bowl. They don't, so you can put that on Garrett. But he doesn't do the hiring. Jerry Jones does.
Well, listen, I said before the season that 10-6, 11-5 was this team's ceiling. When everybody else was saying they're going to win the Super Bowl, I was like, hold on. Let's wait a little bit on that. And that was part roster, part Jason Garrett. Hmm. But when you look at this team, here is in this case, in what Troy Aikman is saying, that your owner is saying that this team is winning the Super Bowl. We need to focus on winning the Super Bowl. When your coach, Jason Garrett, is saying, okay, we need to focus on having the best practice today, that ain't Jerry Jones' fault. That's not Jerry Jones putting undue pressure on a coach like Jason Garrett to do his job any differently. Because no matter what Mr. Rooney would say, no matter what Kevin Colbert would say, that wasn't going to affect my preparation. That shouldn't affect the way that Jason Garrett approaches his job. And the one thing that we have said, or that many people have said in the media, with the reason why Jason Garrett keeps his job is because he can deal with Jerry Jones. So when running the Cowboys and being a part of this organization and coaching this team, you understand that Jerry is going to come first. It's the one team where the media scrum is around the GM and the owner and not the best player first. That's what coaching the Dallas Cowboys is. And Jason Garrett just hasn't gotten it done. Jason Garrett just hasn't made the main thing, which is winning. Jason Garrett hasn't made
can
the
you
adjustment.
Make, can you make the main thing if you have to deal with the owner to keep the job?
Yes, and it's happened. It's happened. No, it's not about keeping your job. It's about winning. Jason Garrett can't focus on being likable. Jason Garrett can't focus on that relationship. He has to focus on winning. Mm-hmm. And if he still is ousted for winning, mm-hmm. then that's on Jerry Jones.
Molly, I appreciate you refocusing the conversation. Thank you very, very much. Because I got a statement. I got a question. Okay. Question, albeit rhetorical. Do we have any evidence that Jerry Jones is calling plays for the Dallas Cowboys?
No.
Because if that's not the case, how do you explain that Ezekiel Elliott rushes the ball 8 times for 56 yards in the first quarter and sees the ball a grand total of 5 times the rest of the game against a 19th-ranked Russian defense that is the Buffalo Bills on Thanksgiving? There's no excuse for that. There are a plethora of instances that we can point to where it is about coaching. And so for me, when I think about Jerry Jones, I'm looking at a guy that accumulated the talent, gave it to you, didn't give you a contract extension. And unless you can show me evidence that this man is literally calling plays or telling you how to run an offense. He gave the man $90 million, $50 million guaranteed, and he's going to want Ezekiel Elliott not to get the football?
Let me give you a different kind of evidence. You gave Jerry Jones credit for spending the money. He gets zero credit for spending money. Zero. There's a salary cap, there's a salary floor. Everyone spends the same in the NFL. No one gets credit for spending extra money. Now, it is true there are some outliers that don't spend money. Like I brought up Marvin Lewis. The Cincinnati Bengals are cheap.
Yep.
They are some cheap organizations. So Jerry Jones deserves credit for not being a cheap owner. Like there are ways to be cheap, but most owners aren't cheap owners in the way that Cincinnati is, right? The Cincinnati organization. Now, so everyone has to spend the same, more or less. Jerry Jones doesn't get credit. You know why he can't outspend others, even though he has the money to, because they generate more revenue?
He was the one that provoked the cap.
He's the one who led the charge for a salary cap.
But that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about what he allocated it to. In other words, he didn't give Ezekiel Elliott $50 million to get five carries the last three quarters.
One of the things that Jerry Jones projects is this big business image. He's willing to spend. I bring up Steinbrenner a lot. He'll ask. No, he's not. He can't. He has handcuffs on that he put there himself.
This is the last thing I have a question on. So Jerry comes out. It's breaking news. He changes his tune, basically that he's done with Garrett. Why is he backtracking now? Are you taking this at face value?
I believe he's backtracking because he was convinced to make the decision to stick with Garrett for the rest of the season instead of firing him like he should have last week. Mm-hmm. And he's doing it because what he doesn't want is for anybody to have an excuse. This is a lame duck, and I ruined the last five games of this season.
Got it.
Nope, I'm not giving you any excuses.
And
the job
their
is yours. Sink or swim.
Yeah.
Sink or swim now.
Well, I think the other thing, he knows that they have a great possibility of winning the NFC East.
Yeah.
But also Jerry Jones is starting to understand the perception of him as an owner, and he wants the next big thing.
Yeah.
He wants the next guy to think that I can come here, run it my way, do things the way I want, and that Jerry Jones will be on board with that. So if he keeps killing this coach in the media, and somebody, I'm going to look at it and say, hey, this is your guy. This is a dude you backed for a decade. Now all of a sudden you're turning tail on him and running. And so Jerry Jones understands those things. You don't get to where he is in life without understanding how to build the perception.
Plus, can the Cowboys get into the playoffs? They probably will. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN Plus.